Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of The Fire Sermon, The Wasteland by T.S. Eliot. Come, let's go to the poem. He starts by saying about the river. He says, the river's tent is broken. That is, actually when trees are there, the leaves all will dry during the autumn season and they'll fall on the river. And it will look as though the river is covered by a tent. But now he says, the river's tent is broken. The last fingers of leaf clutch and sink into the wet bank. And even the last leaf which was floating on the river has now sunk into the wet bank. The wind crosses the brown land unheard. Because there are no trees, no one is able to hear the sound of the wind. And then he says, the nymphs are departed, sweet Thames, run softly till I end my song. And this line is taken from Spenser's Prothalamion. And we know that Spenser would have described River Thames in its glorious days. And it can be compared how Thames has changed after the World War I and how it was at one time during Spenser's time. And he says even the nymphs who were very happily playing around there have gone away from here. And then he says, the river bears no empty bottles, sandwich papers, silk handkerchiefs, cardboard boxes, cigarette ends, or other testimony of summer nights. That is, earlier people used to come during summer nights and stay near the banks of the River Thames and spend their time there. And in the next day, they used to find a lot of empty bottles, sandwich papers, silk handkerchiefs, cardboard boxes, cigarette ends and many things to say that these people were, there were so much people there in the night time. But now he says there's nothing like that. That means that no one comes in the night. There's no one to come in the night to spend their time near the Thames. And then he again says, the nymphs are departed and their friends, the loitering hairs of city directors. He says, the nymphs, along with their friends, have left the city. Departed, have left no addresses, and we don't know where they have gone because they have not given us any address, so we can't trace them back. And so, by the waters of Leman, Leman is here a reference to River Geneva, it's a French reference, and he says, I sat down and wept. Here we can take that wept can refer to the people of Israel who were exiled to Babylon. And they cried by the river because they were thinking about Jerusalem. So here he says, I sat down and wept. And he goes back to Prothalamion and says, sweet Thames, run softly till I end my song. Sweet Thames, run softly, for I speak not loud or long. But at my back in a cold blast I hear the rattle of the bones and chuckle spread far from ear to ear. Now again the rattle of the bones we saw in the game of chess in the previous part of the wasteland, and now again he is bringing a reference to it, and he goes back to the rat. The rat seems to be a constant one in all the parts. A rat crept softly through the vegetation, dragging its slimy belly on the bank. While I was fishing in the dull canal on a winter evening round behind the gas house, musing upon the king, my brother's wreck, and on the king, my father's death before him. So now he says, when he was fishing, he was thinking about his brother's wreck and his father's death. And at that time, white bodies naked on the low damp ground and bones cast in a little low dry garret rattled by the rat's foot only ear to ear. Now again, the rattle of the rats, where we saw in the game of chess, where these rats are said to be very dangerous, for they even will eat the dead man's bones. And he says that, but at my back from time to time I hear the sound of horns and motors, which shall bring sweetney to Mrs. Porter in the spring. Now the sweetney and Mrs. Porter is again a reference to the Parliament Bee by John Dace. It's a 17th century work, and it tells us the story of Actaeon and Diana. The story goes like this, like Actaeon comes to meet Diana. But he finds that she is taking bath. So in order to surprise her, he takes the form of a stag. Actually, he doesn't realize his dogs are there. And his dogs see the stag, and not knowing it is their master who has come in the form of stag, they kill him. So this here, Sweetney refers to Actaeon, and Mrs. Porter is Diana. And he says, "On the moon shone bright on Mrs. Porter and on her daughter. They washed their feet in soda water." So she says that Mrs. Porter, that is Diana and her daughter, are waiting. Now he says, "Et oses voxed infants chanted dance la cape," which means, "Oh, these children voice singing in the choir." But they are singing in the choir. To others, it just comes as sound like twit, 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 jug, 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 jug. So rudely forced tarot. Now again, the reference goes to the game of chess about Philomena's story. Those who have not seen the video can see that video to know the story. Unreal city under the brown fog of a winter noon. Mr. Huguenites, the Samra merchant, unshaven with a pocket full of currents, CIF London, documents at sight, asked me in demotic French, to luncheon at the Cannon Street Hotel, followed by a weekend at the Metropole. So now the writer says about this merchant, and this is the same merchant who came in the part 1, the burial of the dead. The one-eyed merchant who came in the tarot card, and he says he asked me to come to the Cannon Street Hotel, and this hotel is said to be a very famous place for homosexuals to come and meet. And he says, "We'll follow it up with a weekend at the Metropole." Then he goes on to say, "At the violet hour, when the eyes and back turn upward from the desk, when the human engine waits like a taxi throbbing waiting, I, Tiresias." Now this Tiresias is again a reference to a Greek mythological character who had both the male and the female features. So this Tiresias has the experience of both the male and the female, and it is said to be that Tiresias was blind but could see what will happen in the future. So he can tell you beforehand itself what will happen in the future. And here he says, "I, Tiresias, though blind, throbbing between two lives." Two lives here means to the male and the female. "Old man with wrinkled female breast, can see at the violet hour, the evening hour that strives homeward and brings a sailor home from sea." So he says, I can tell about the future, and at that time itself he told in the future, that is in the evening when the sailors are returning home, he has seen the typist home at tea time. He sees a typist in her home, clears her breakfast, lights her stove and lays out food in tins. Out of the window, perilously spread, her drying combinations touched by the sun's last rays. So now she is preparing the food in the evening. And outside the window is her clothes. She has already dried her clothes. And on the divan up-piled at night her bed, stockings, slippers, camisoles and stays. So in her bed, what she has removed in the night is still there. "I, Tiresias, old man with wrinkled dugs, perceived the scene and foretold the rest." So he says, I have told what will happen on that day at that time itself. "I too awaited the expected guest." So here also we find the typist waiting for a guest, like how in the second part, that is the game of chess, we saw the rich lady waiting for her lover. "He, the young man, carbon color, arrives." So the expected guest arrives. "A small house agent's clerk with one bold stare." So he comes, the person who comes is a clerk. And he just stares at her. "One of the low on whom assurance sits as a silk hat on a Bradford milliner. The time is now propitious as he guesses. The meal is ended. She is bored and tired. Endeavours to engage her in caresses." So they have a meal and she is bored and she encourages him to caress her. "Why, which still are unreproved if undesired." Okay, it was not undesired, but at the same time, it is still unreproved. "Flushed and decided, he assaults at once. Exploring hands encounter no defense." She does not try to defend herself. "His vanity requires no response," and he is also not waiting for any response. "And make a welcome of indifference. And I, Tiresias, have foresuffered all enacted on the same divan or bed. I who have sat by Thebes below the wall and walked among the lowest of the dead. Bestows one final patronizing kiss." And this clerk, he gives a final kiss and groups his way, finding the stairs unlit, and he just leaves without even bidding farewell. "And she turns and looks a moment in the glass, hardly aware of her departed lover." And she is also not bothered about the person who has left. "Her brain allows one half-formed thought to pass. Well, now that's done, and I am glad it's over." So these are the thoughts which run in her mind after her physical relationship with the lover. When lovely women stoops to folly. Now this can refer to Oliver Goldsmith's Vicar of Wakefield. And paces about her room again alone. She smooths her hair with automatic hand and puts a record on the gramophone. And she gets up and she puts on music in a gramophone. And he says, the writer says, this music crept by me upon the waters. And he says, this music takes him to the waters. And along the strand up Queen Victoria Street. So he describes a city. Oh, city, city. I can sometimes hear beside a public bar in Lower Thames Street the pleasant weaning of a mandolin and a chatter, clatter and a chatter from within. Where fishmen lounge at noon, where the walls of Magnus Martyr hold inexplicable splendor of lawny and white and gold. So now he's describing a church there. And then he goes on to talk about the river. He says the river sweats oil and tar. He says how dirty the river is now, spoilt with oil and tar floating on it. The barges drift with a turning tide, red sails wide, to leeward swing on the heavy spar. The barges watch drifting logs down Greenwich Ridge past the Isles of Dogs. We la la la, li la, wa la la, li la. Now he says that the daughter of the Thames, they are now saying about their last gold. And so they are lamenting like this. And then he straightaway goes on to Queen Elizabeth I and the Earl of Leicester. Elizabeth and Leicester beating oars, that is they are going in a ship. The stern was formed, a gilded shell, red and gold, the brisk swell rippled both shores, southwest wind, carried downstream, the peal of bells. Now the ship is just tearing the shores and it is going southwards and it is carried by the stream, the peal of bell. White towers, we la la la, dia. La, 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 la. But the nymphs, the daughters of Thames are still lamenting. And here he says, trams and dusty trees, Highbury bore me. Richmond and Kew undid me. By Richmond I raised my knees, supping on the floor of a narrow canon. My feet are at Moorgate and my heart under my feet after the event he wept. He promised a new start. I made no comment. What should I resent? Oh, on Market Sands, I can connect nothing with nothing. The broken fingernails of dirty hands. So now he says that how people have changed their attitudes in life. And he again talks about Queen Elizabeth, who says, my people, humble people who expect nothing. She's not bothered about her lover's declarations. And only thinks about the people who expect nothing. La la, to Carthage then I came, burning, 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 burning. So these are the lines from Buddha's sermon. And this fire sermon is also, the title is also taken from the sermon by Buddha. And it ends like this, O Lord, thou pluckest me out. O Lord, thou pluckest burning. So he ends this part abruptly here. I hope you've understood. And if you have anything to add on, please do write it in the description box. And the notes also I've given in the description because Professor Sayambu has said it will be a better method which will be very beneficial for the students who are reading Wasteland. So I have given the notes in the description which I hope will be useful for you. And if you have anything to add on to it, please do write it in the comment box. It will be useful for others. Like the video, share it with your friends. And if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.